All right, so this is my first video with the Fuji X-H1. I'm shooting this with the 23mm at f2, ISO 1600, and in the Eterna mode. For audio, I'm using the Rode VideoMic Pro Plus, and I've got it set to plus 20 decibels gain, and I turned the audio in camera all the way to, I think it was minus 30, the bottom level, whatever that is. So the point of this video is multifold. First thing, I just want to see the quality and see how well it grades. From this point forward, I'm gonna go ahead and apply a grade to the video as of right now. So, here's what I wanted to do today. Now, for prime lenses, I currently own the 23, 35, and 50mm f2 lenses. The good lenses, I like them a lot. I bought them because they're primarily weather sealed. I have had the 1.4 versions and 1.2 versions in the past, but I sold them a year or two ago because I needed money for other stuff. Now I'm wondering if I should have went ahead and kept those or maybe repurchased them. And, of course, that's quite a bit of money. And these lenses are perfectly fine. So I want to do an experiment. I wanted to see how the quality of these lenses are, the F2 lenses, compared to some of my mirrorless lenses, specifically I have a Leica 28mm f2 Summicron, a newer version, 50mm f2 Summicron, and also a 75mm APO Summicron, all f2 lenses, and I want to see how those compare newer Leica lenses to the Fuji equivalents, being that I have the Fuji Leica M adapter. Now, granted, the 28mm compared to the 23mm of the Fuji isn't a direct comparison, but it's just a lens that I have. And then for the 35mm, I own a Zeiss 35mm f1.4. I want to see how that compares to the Fuji f2. So what I'm going to do now is go ahead and put the pictures side by side. I'll just kind of talk about what they are. I'm just going to show them directly as they came out of the camera. I am not doing any post-processing at all. So there's going to be some color variation and exposure variation. It wasn't a very scientific test shot. I just set something up upstairs, a mobile my daughter made this morning, and a window and some books in the background. Nothing too serious. What I'm looking for is just to see optically which is better, the Fuji lenses or the Leica M lenses adapted to work on the Fuji system. At the end of this video, please leave some comments down below. Let me know what you think of the quality of the sound, the video quality, and how does it autofocus on my face and things like that. All right, thanks.
Let's take a look at the images and just compare the Leica and Zeiss lenses to the Fuji lenses. So the first one we're looking at is the Zeiss 35mm f1.4 lens. And I shot this at f1.4. And that's what it looks like. Now, in order to compare it to the Fuji, this isn't a fair comparison because the Fuji can't go to 1.4. So here's the Zeiss at f2, and you can see it looks much better. I like the bokeh, it's quite nice and pleasing. And the focus was on the center yellow part of the mobile. So here's the Fuji lens. Now, one thing you will notice is the Fuji lens is corrected, the Zeiss is not. The slight difference in lighting is just because I shot these minutes apart, and it was mainly lit by natural light from outside. So here's the Zeiss, and here's the Fuji. Let's go ahead and zoom in and take a look. So this is the Fuji lens, and that's the Zeiss. They're both good. I mean, it's really splitting hairs. So why would I use the Zeiss lens? Well, if I need to go down to 1.4, I guess that's a good reason to use that lens in lower light. Other than that, I really don't see much of a big difference between the two. Here's the Zeiss, here's the Fuji. Again, the Fuji's corrected. The Zeiss might be more contrasty. Let's go ahead and take a look at them at 2.8. So here's the Zeiss at 2.8. And then that's the Fuji. Now again, the Fuji seems brighter, but again, they were shot minutes apart. I could always brighten the Zeiss in post. As far as the background, here's the Zeiss. Notice the bokeh over here. Or bokeh, I guess, is how a lot of people pronounce it. That's the Fuji. Again, very similar, kind of splitting hairs. Let's go ahead and zoom in. Here is the Zeiss at 2.8. And that's the Fuji at 2.8. I might almost argue that the Zeiss is sharper. Especially here in the center. Yeah, here I'll say the Zeiss is sharper at 2.8 than the Fuji. And now here is the Zeiss at f4. And that's the Fuji. I think the Fuji is a great lens. I mean, especially for the price, there's nothing wrong with it. But I have zero complaints using the Zeiss. I mean, if I look at the sharpness here in the center, this is the Zeiss lens. Notice the yellow. And that's the Fuji. It's close, but I can definitely see a little more detail here in the Zeiss versus the Fuji. Which makes sense. The Zeiss is a more expensive lens. So especially at f2.8 and f4, I'll say the Zeiss really shines. Let's go ahead and take a look at some more. Now here's the 23mm. This is not a fair comparison. I don't have a 23mm Leica, but I do a 28mm. So this one we're kind of going to skip over. Here's the Fuji. It's a nice lens. That's the Leica 28mm Summicron. Completely different field of view. I thought there'd be more closeness, but there's not. I do like this Leica lens. It's very sharp. This is at f2 versus the Fuji. Again, it's not the same. You can't really compare it. If we look at the Fuji at 2.8 versus the Leica, again, the Leica just does a beautiful job, but it should. It's an expensive lens. Fuji and then the Leica again. So, bottom line, you can use it. I am noticing some smearing down here in the corner, but also that could just be the bokeh. Here is the Fuji 50mm f2 at f2 versus the Leica Summicron. Now here, I'm seeing a big difference in sharpness. Here's the Leica. Here's the Fuji. The Fuji's not bad, but it kind of has kind of a glowy tone to it. Whereas the... similar. Fuji and the Leica. Boy, that's a tough one to call. Okay, so here's the Fuji at 2.8. Again, this is the 50mm. And here's the Summicron Leica at 2.8. I think the bokeh is a little bit nicer on the Leica. Let's just take a look and see how in focus it is versus the Fuji. Fuji is definitely brighter, but I could always brighten up the Leica as well. And here's the Fuji at f4 versus the Leica at f4. I guess we wanted more contrast or just to shoot the Leica for fun. If I didn't have any of these Fuji lenses, I'd be perfectly happy the way the manual focus is of the Leicas. And then here's something that the Fuji can't do. This is the 75mm Summicron APO at f2, 2.8, and f4. This lens is a fantastic lens. I use it for portraits on my Leica, and I can see using this a lot with the Fuji X-H1. Okay, thanks for checking this part of the video out.